Now, the fork in the road then is, do I add or do I switch? Patient takes an antidepressant, SSRI, inadequate outcome according to the patient's lived experience. Do I stop that medication in its tracks and switch to something else now? Or do I add something on? If I add something on, do I add antidepressants together? Or do I add an atypical? This is a question we face daily. Well, there's been four studies now in the last 5 to 6 years, 5 to 7 years, that have addressed this very question. This question has concluded with the following answer, that if a patient is added and that index antidepressants partially effective, the add-on may have a slight advantage with switching. So we're looking at bupropion as the add-on. Bupropion is the switch to, or an atypical antipsychotic. And in this study, which was done in Veterans Affairs hospitals, and this study done in geriatric in the 65 and older population with depression, it's hard to see, but that red rectangle denotes the next step strategy, the add-on atypical, add-on bupropion, or the switch. Consistently, the add-on is doing better than the switch, but the switch is to bupropion, which is monoaminergic. Now, nowadays, it would be more interesting to look at SSRI, inadequate response, comparing the atypical add-on versus adding bupropion or mirtazapine versus switching to a dextromethorphan, a completely different mechanism. That's more interesting. But what I wanted to also highlight is that antipsychotics do better than the antidepressant as the add-on for symptoms of irritability, dysphoria, agitation. Again, that resonates true clinically. But what I want to not forget to mention is, remember that slide I showed that only 25% of people with depression move on to the next step? When they move on to the next step, it's not for 6 to 9 months, that's a long time, and most often they're getting benzos added, bupropion or mirtazapine. And the evidence for those agents is not considered what we say level one, large randomized double-blind placebo-controlled trials. Some people say to me, well, atypicals have too many side effects. Well, turns out that the tolerability, as evidenced by the percentage of side effects, severe side effects leading to treatment discontinuation, not a whole lot different between atypical and add-on antidepressant.